okay? But when we say that molecular or vital theory is a better theory, that doesn't mean that these two theories are any less, because whenever there is certain kind of, you know, whenever there is certain kind of theory, development of any theory or hypothesis, jitni bhi previous studies hoti hai, they are equally important. If Bohr's theory was not there, we would not have been able to understand the Schrodinger's theory, your wave mechanical identity of the electron. Okay, so that whenever we study some some modified theory or some advanced theory, the older theories are always equally relevant, and that is why we study valence bond theory till now. Still, there are many properties which cannot be explained by valence bond theory that we now understand. But still, we study this theory because there were certain, things that were discussed in those theory and which were utilized as such in the molecular orbital theory or crystal field theory. Okay, so if you remember your BSc first semester classes, so valence bond theory is typically that the electrons present in the valence orbital, they are involved in the bonding, right? And we identify a central atom. Central atom undergoes hybridization to provide orbital of equal energy for the upcoming electrons from other atoms. Okay, and then these hybrid orbitals will be available for bonding with the other atoms. Okay, this is kind of essence of valence bond theory, that there is hybridization of central atom, and then what is the need of hybridization? And how people understood that there is hybridization going on. Okay, so this is metal mein to hum log baad mein ja sakte hain. If okay, just let me start this. Okay, so I'm starting a whiteboard, but you don't have to click the link. I will just share this screen. Okay. So yes, I was talking about that, how people understood that hybridization is going on and what is the need of hybridization. Suppose if you have a carbon atom, okay, what is the electronic configuration of carbon?
One s two, two s two, two p two.
Yes. So this is yes. So suppose, see, the drawing is not very good because it's difficult to draw with the mouse. Suppose this is methane, right? CH4. Okay, so if we have to form four covalent bonds, so how we will do that? The outer electronic configuration of carbon is 2s2 2p2, right? That means we have to move one of the s electron in the p orbital. Is it so? This is the 2s2, and yes, these are the, yes, these are the 2p2, right? So the excited state electronic configuration will be something like this: 1 2s, and there will be 3 electron in the p orbital, right? Is it so? These are the s electrons, and these are the 3 p electrons. Yes, and if we form 4 bonds, and that means one hydrogen is overlapping with the electron present in the s orbital, and 3 hydrogens are overlapping with the electrons, not overlapping, forming bond with the electrons in the p orbital. So in that case, will all the 4 bonds will be equivalent? Agar ek hydrogen s orbital ke electrons se bond, no. Yes, so that is the basis of hybridization. People found that all the 4 bonds are equal in methane, right? All the 4 bonds are equal in methane. That means there will be the orbitals of carbon which are being involved in the bonding with hydrogen. These orbitals should be equal, right? So how we can make these orbitals equal? That is only through hybridization. That means this s and these 3 p electrons, they undergo hybridization, and there is sp3 hybridization and generation of 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. Then hydrogen overlaps with one of the hybrid orbitals, right? With each of the hybrid orbitals. Okay, so this explains that why all the 4 CH bonds are equal in this one. Okay, so this is the primary essence of valence bond theory, that here we start with the hybridization of central atom, right? Vacant habit orbitals are utilized for formation of coordinate bond with the ligands. Okay, so whenever we were studying normal compounds without the involvement of metals, so there we said hybridization of central atom. अगर हम मेटल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस को पढ़ रहे हैं देन वी से हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ सेंट्रल मेटल एटम राइट सो वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी फोकसेस ऑन हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ सेंट्रल मेटल एटम आफ्टर हाइब्रिडाइजेशन इट जनरेट वेकेंट हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स एंड दीज वेकेंट हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स आर यूटिलाइज्ड इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट बॉन्ड विद द लिगेंड्स ओके लिगेंड्स आर द एंटिटी विच आर इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच एंड विच आर गोइंग टू डोनेट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टू द मेटल एटम बिकॉज एटम्स आर ऑलवेज मेटल एटम्स आर ऑलवेज इलेक्ट्रॉन डेफिशिएंट कंपाउंड्स राइट दे ऑलवेज नीड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ओके दैट इज व्हाई दे आर इलेक्ट्रो पॉजिटिव ओके सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट थ्योरी दैट हैज टू बी स्टडीड दैट इज वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी नेक्स्ट इज द क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी So after studying valence bond theory, we will be studying the limitations of valence bond theory. That is our actually first topic. Second is the crystal field theory. This theory is very interesting, very important. So first of all, crystal field theory, the name crystal came from the fact because this theory was given to explain bonding in certain crystalline compounds. Initially, it was given to explain bonding in crystalline compounds, and that is why the name crystal came in the crystal field theory. Okay, field word comes from the ligand field, right? Because ligand is considered as the point negative charge. If you look at the crystal field theory, in valence bond theory, we just utilize the concept of hybridization and we form the coordinate bond with the vacant hybrid orbitals. That was the valence bond theory. What happens in crystal field theory? It was given by Hans Bethe. Okay, crystal field theory, what we devise, we say that ligands are being considered as the point negative charges. That means if there is certain ligand like chloride or ammonia or water or certain, so we will consider them as a point negative charge, minus charge, right? And if something is pointly, if something is negatively charged, it is going to exert a negative field, right? Electrostatic field. It is going to exert an electrostatic field. Yes? Is there something?
No, ma'am. The same thing I was just speaking. Electrostatic force. Yeah.
Yes, yes. So that is why when this word field in the crystal field theory is the electrostatic field of the ligand. Why we are talking about electrostatic field? Because we are considering the ligand as charged. हमने उसको एक Q charge, Q और minus charge की तरह treat किया है ligand को. We did not consider the orbitals of the ligand. हमने बस ये देखा कि metal central metal atom है, उसके orbitals है, but ligands के orbital नहीं है. Ligand को हमने केवल एक negative charge की तरह consider किया है. Okay? Since metals are electropositive, so that means metal or ligand के बीच का जो भी interaction होगा, according to crystal field theory, this will be electrostatic interaction. Okay? Why electrostatic interaction? Because there we are considering the ligand as negative charge, and if something is negatively charged, it is going to produce a electrostatic field, right? And your metal is present in the electrostatic field of the ligand, which is being considered as the negative charge. ठीक है सो दिस टर्म क्रिस्टल फील्ड फील्ड वर्ड कम्स फ्रॉम द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फील्ड ऑफ द लिगेंड सो हियर यू सी इट इज रिटन लिगेंड्स आर कंसीडर्ड एज द पॉइंट नेगेटिव चार्जेस व्हाइल मेटल सेंटर्स आर सपोज्ड टू मेंटेन वेव मैकेनिकल आइडेंटिटी ये जो सेकेंड लाइन लिखी है मेटल सेंटर्स आर सपोज्ड टू मेंटेन वेव मैकेनिकल आइडेंटिटी इसका क्या मतलब है वेव मैकेनिकल आइडेंटिटी का मतलब है we are going to consider the orbitals of the metals not the orbitals of the ligands hum log ligand ko keval ek negative charge ki tarah consider karenge but we will consider the orbitals of the metals right that is why we have formed p2g and eg set of orbitals right d orbitals so crystal field theory comes from the fact that we have to consider the negative field exerted by the ligands right our metal is present in the electrostatic field of the ligand and that is why the term field comes in the crystal field theory okay and the any interaction which is present between the ligand and the metal is always electropositive in nature right electrostatic in nature सो क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी में जो लिगेंड और मेटल के बीच का इंटरेक्शन था इट वाज ऑलवेज कंसिडर्ड टू बी इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक इन नेचर राइट. वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी में हमने कोवेलेंट इंटरेक्शन पढ़े थे बट क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी सेज दैट एनी काइंड ऑफ इंटरेक्शन विच इज प्रेजेंट बिटवीन द लिगेंड एंड द मेटल इज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक इन नेचर. ओके सो हियर देयर इज अ पावर कट इन आवर डिपार्टमेंट. ओके सो जस्ट प्लीज होल्ड आई विल जस्ट चेक इट दैट हाउ वी कैन see for the power cut. Just wait a second.
Ma'am,
yes,
sometimes it might found that the ligand they not only possesses the negative point charge, sometimes mm-hmm. they may be the neutral.
Yes. So you know this is something which is ahead, which we are going to study next, and this is the actually one of the limitation of crystal field theory, because somehow it cannot explain the, you know, this. While you have said so that neutral ligands, one of the example is CO, carbon monoxide, right? CO, carbonyl ligands, these are one of the strongest ligand present, right? And these are neutral ligands. According to crystal field theory, there should not be any bonding between this ligand and the metal center since it is neutral, but it is one of the strongest ligand, right? So this is one of the limitation, and that is why we go to molecular orbital theory, because CO is a neutral ligand. It is a very good pi acceptor, and that is why there is a very strong bonding. So that we will study. Okay, I was just talking about crystal field theory, and there are certain limitations with this theory, and that is why, you know, molecular orbital theory came. Okay, so just there is a power cut in chemistry department right now. Okay, just wait a few seconds. Just let me see that how we can manage the class, otherwise I have to stop it. Okay, just wait 5 minutes. Okay, so yes, I was talking about, so this was a good question, that we see that there are always neutral ligands which are very strong ligands, and since crystal field theory only says that ligands will be yes, so dipole ka question hai, there is water, right? Water mein we can understand there is a dipole and not CO. Okay, CO clearly is because of pi acceptance property. Someone has asked this question in chat box, that can we consider a kind of dipole in CO? So I will say no, because now we know that dipole theory is not going to explain bonding in CO. CO mein strong bonding ka reason hai keval aur keval because it is a very good pi acceptor, and that is why it has a very strong bonding capacity. Okay. So this will be explained by molecular orbital theory, because as a molecular orbital theory CO se kyun explain karenge, because when I am saying that CO is a good pi acceptor, right, that means we are considering the orbitals of the CO as well, right? So naturally it cannot be explained by crystal field theory. Molecular orbital theory, in fact, what does it say here? In molecular orbital theory, it is understood that there will be overlap of the atomic orbitals of metal and ligand group orbitals. Okay, so molecular orbital theory is actually not in syllabus, but still I will try to explain few of these points. So we have seen that in crystal field theory, we are not considering the orbital of the ligands, we are only considering the orbitals of metals. Okay, in what happens in molecular orbital theory, molecular orbital theory says, suppose example is CO, so all the, suppose we are talking about a complex where there is MCO6 kind of complex. M is your metal, CO is the carbonyl ligand, and there are six carbonyl ligands are present. Okay, so according to molecular orbital theory, these orbitals of carbon, orbitals of oxygen, they and all these six COs, they are going to overlap and they are going to form ligand group orbitals. And ligand group orbitals are formed in such a way so that they have matching symmetry with the metal orbitals, okay? And then there is overlap of the metal and the ligand group orbitals. So molecular orbital theory says jitne bhi ligand ke orbital hai, they are going to overlap to form ligand group orbitals. And now the ligand group orbitals will actually overlap with the metal, empty metal orbitals or atomic orbitals of the metal, right? So this is a molecular orbital overlap theory. Okay, so
ma'am, like something like lock key structure.
Lock key structure, this is similar to molecular orbital theory that you have studied in first semester. Agar aapko yaad hoga, CO ka hi aapne NO ya CO ka molecular orbital picture padha hai, theek hai? So what happened in that case, that carbon ke atomic orbitals overlap karte hain oxygen ke atomic orbitals se, aur nitrogen ke atomic orbitals oxygen ke atomic orbitals ke saath overlap karke equal number of molecular orbitals generate karte hain, theek hai? ओवरलैप एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स के ओवरलैप के लिए कुछ कंडीशंस हैं. इफ यू रिमेम्बर किस तरह के एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स ओवरलैप करते हैं, उनकी सिमेट्री सेम होनी चाहिए, देन ओनली दे विल बी ओवरलैपिंग, अदरवाइज दे वोंट ओवरलैप. ओके, सो जस्ट अप्लाई द सेम थिंग इन द केस ऑफ मेटल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. मेटल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस में हमारे पास दो तरह के क्या ग्रुप है, एक हमारे पास मेटल के एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स है, दूसरा हमारे पास लिगेंड्स है. लिगेंड में सपोज अमोनिया है, तो अमोनिया का भी तो एक मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल पिक्चर होगा, एंड नाइट्रोजन और तीन हाइड्रोजन के जो एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल ओवरलैप करेंगे तो अमोनिया का मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल डायग्राम तैयार होगा, ठीक है? सो क्योंकि मोनो एटॉमिक लिगेंड अगर होता, सपोज क्लोरीन है, ब्रोमीन है, आयोडीन है, तो ठीक है, दीज आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म लाइक क्लोराइड्स के साथ बॉन्ड बन गया ब्रोमाइड, वो सिंगल एटॉमिक है, ठीक है, मोनो एटॉमिक है. बट जहां पे हमारे पास पॉली एटॉमिक लिगेंड्स है, वाटर है, अमोनिया है, CO है, NO है, ऑक्सीजन है, नाइट्रोजन है, these are polyatomic ligands, okay? So unke case mein how we will be going to explain the bonding. So what we say that there are orbitals of metals. Ek humne ek group bana ke rakhi hai ki ye metal orbitals hai, inki ye symmetry hai, okay? Now what we did, now we have prepared six ammonia ligands are there, so we will be preparing ligand group orbitals by considering the orbitals of the ammonia, right? अमोनिया के ऑर्बिटल्स कैसे बने हैं, नाइट्रोजन और तीन हाइड्रोजन के एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स से ओवरलैप करके. तो लिगेंड ग्रुप ऑर्बिटल्स को, वही लिगेंड ग्रुप ऑर्बिटल्स को हम प्रिपेयर करते हैं जिनकी मैचिंग सिमेट्री मेटल ऑर्बिटल्स में होगी, देन ओनली मेटल और लिगेंड के बीच में ओवरलैप होगा. आई अंडरस्टैंड दिस सीम्स कॉम्प्लिकेटेड और दिस साउंड्स कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, बट वेन वी सी द एमओ पिक्चर इट विल बी मोर क्लियर, इट विल बी बेटर टू अंडरस्टैंड. Only thing is important, that is overlap should always be done between the orbitals of similar symmetry. Okay, so we have to have matching orbitals on metal and we have to have matching orbitals on the ligands. So ligand may we prepare a ligand group orbitals, we chalk out the symmetry of those orbitals and then we match these orbitals with the atomic orbitals and then we form the molecular orbital. Okay, molecular orbital in metal complexes is little bit complex. When we जब हम N2 या C2 और O2 और NO और CO का MO डायग्राम हमने पढ़ा, इट वाज वन ऑफ द सिंपलेस्ट मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल डायग्राम, ठीक है? थोड़ा सा आगे गए, वाटर का मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल डायग्राम पढ़ा, SO2 का पढ़ा, दिस इज लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्ट. ओके, मेटल कॉम्प्लेक्स यू इमेजिन लाइक NiCO4, निकिल टेट्रा कार्बोनिल कंपाउंड है, एंड नाउ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रिपेयर अ मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल डायग्राम ऑफ दिस कॉम्पाउंड. Okay, so it is very much complicated, very much complex, but it can be prepared in a systematic manner. First we have to identify the orbitals present on the metal, we have to identify the symmetry of those orbitals, then we have to find out the matching symmetry orbitals on the ligand, which we call as the ligand group orbitals, and then we have to make we have to overlap these orbitals and then we have to form the molecular orbitals. Okay, what is okay, that we will study later in our syllabus. That we have to cover is the valence bond theory and crystal film theory. Molecular orbital theory is as such not in the syllabus, but when we study the transitions there we require the molecular orbital theory. So few diagrams of molecular orbital picture of certain complexes that we will see in this class. Okay, so Okay, someone said that it is kind of lock and key hypothesis. You can say it is kind of recognition. You know, the recognition is what that is some, you know, there are matching symmetries present on both set of orbitals. One is on the metal, one is on the ligand group orbitals. And then they are going to overlap because their symmetry is matching. And whenever we form, if you remember linear combination of atomic orbital concept, right, there are certain conditions which has to be satisfied before forming a molecular orbital, okay? So, we keep those things in mind before constructing the molecular orbital diagram. One thing is also very important. Suppose आपको किसी ने बोला कि एक random complex का MO picture prepare करिए, किसी भी random complex का, ठीक है? It is not easy, okay? It is not easy because बहुत ढेर सारे permutation combinations हैं, symmetry operations हैं. तो randomly if someone asks to prepare a certain kind of molecular orbital picture, अगर आपने पहले से नहीं पढ़ा है उसके बारे में, आपको पहले से नहीं पता है, it is very difficult to prepare it out of nowhere. You have to have certain idea ki is tarah ke complex ka aisa molecular orbital picture present hota hai. Aisa main kyun keh rahi hu? Kyunki jo molecular orbital picture books mein dikhata hai ya aapko apne net pe dekha hoga, aajkal bahut complex compound ke bhi MO picture generate hote hain jo people doing research. So that is being generated by the softwares. Okay, theoretical chemistry, theoretical, there are plenty of theoretical chemists who are only doing the you know, calculation part. They are having certain, they have very good softwares and they generate the molecular orbital picture of any complex, whether it has 4-5 metal centers, 6 metal centers, 8 metal centers. You name any compound, the molecular orbital picture can be generated. So I'm telling you this because what we study at this level are one of the simplest molecular orbital diagrams for metal complexes. Yet you have to have prior idea. अगर आपको कोई अचानक से बोल दे कि इस complex का molecular orbital picture बनाइए, it will never be coming, it will never be an exact picture जब तक आपको पहले से कोई idea ना हो कि इस तरह के complex में कैसा molecular orbital diagram आता है. Because of की symmetry हम पहले से बिना देखे नहीं बता सकते, ligand group orbitals को हम पहले से बिना जाने identify नहीं कर सकते. तो molecular orbital picture बनाने के पहले you have to have certain idea, okay? So we will look at it. पहले इस पे confused नहीं होते हैं. Let us start with the valence bond and crystal field theory. Then we will move to the molecular orbital theory. ऐसा ये है crystal field theory. Already you have studied few in you know 12th में आपके है, but वो बहुत ही कम है, बहुत ही introductory knowledge है that I have seen those books. क्योंकि उस level पे उतना आपको पढ़ना भी नहीं था. तो क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी के देर आर प्लेंटी ऑफ एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ दिस थ्योरी एंड उन्हीं के बेसिस पे आपके कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स में क्वेश्चंस भी आते हैं. डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चंस अब बहुत कम पूछा जाता है. ऑलवेज पीपल आस्क क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर यू नो व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन द एप्लीकेटिव पार्ट ऑफ दिस थ्योरीज. सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद द वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी, मूव टू लिमिटेशंस ऑफ वैलेंस बॉन्ड थ्योरी, वी विल कम टू क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी. Crystal field theory we will study in detail because after BSc 5th semester you are not going to study it ever, okay? But you are going to apply it everywhere, right? So you have to study it in detail. And then if we have time left, we will go to molecular orbital theory. Just for your sake, it is not in your syllabus, but I always teach it in the class because it is important to understand the electronic transitions, okay? So this was the first unit. So all of you already know that when we study the crystal field splitting, it is only on the basis of orientation of the d orbitals. There are 5 d orbitals: dxy, dzx, dyz, dx square minus y square, and dz square. So these all orbitals, these 5 d orbitals, based on the orientation of these orbitals in the ligand field, in the presence of the electrostatic field of the ligand, what is the orientation of these orbitals? Based on that, we study the crystal field splitting. Okay, octahedral, tetrahedral, and square planar. This all comes from the orientation of the orbital. Okay, and the shape of the molecule is decided. So that we will study in detail. I'm just introducing today only a few things. One thing is important: dxy, zx, yz, and these dz square, y square, and the dx square minus y square. What is the difference between these d orbitals? x, y, y, z and z, x. These orbitals are always, the lobes are directed in between the axis. You see, dx, y, z, x, dy, z. You see, the lobes are in between the x, y, z axis. They are not directed along the axis, okay? For dx square minus y square and dz square, the lobes, you can see, they are directed along the x, y, z axis, okay? So clearly these orbitals are different. हम लोग पहले d orbitals जब valence bond theory पढ़ते हैं, तो all the 5d orbitals we formed in one level, right? But it is not correct because all the 5d orbitals are not similar. These have the lobes directed d, y, z, x, z, x, and x, y have the lobes directed in between the axis. X square minus y square and d z square have the lobe directed along the axis. So आपका already yes.
Is dz square is the combination of the dy square, yes, dz, yes, square and dx,
yes, yes,
square?
Yes, yes, yes. So this comes, sometimes people ask this question that sare d orbitals mein char char lobe present hai, but only dz square is something which has only two lobe and a collar in the xy plane, okay? So if you have studied the book of, you know, that Hui, Kitter and Peter, okay, there it is written in very, very clearly कि dz square orbital is actually a linear combination of two orbitals. One is dz square minus x square and other is dz square minus y square. Okay, just like dx square minus y square. So because there is linear combination of two orbitals, dz square minus dx square and dz square minus g minus y square. Okay. So there is one second, there is increased electron density in the z direction because dono mein dz square common tha, minus x square and minus y square because of reduced electron density in xy plane, the collar is present in the xy plane. Okay, now the question, someone was asking something.
Yes ma'am. Ma'am, sometime it is asked that before the mixing ki what is the number of d orbitals. So before the mixing, it means that what is the meaning of before mixing? Is this hypothetical concept for just understanding this point? Yeah, actually there is a meaning of before mixing and the after mixing. Before mixing they have the 6d orbitals and after mixing they have the only 5d orbitals,
you know. Yes, it should not be called as before and after mixing. Okay, whenever we generate the wave equation for these orbitals, we already start with the dz square as the dz square and reduced density in xy plane. It should not be asked before and after mixing. Okay, it is confusing, but sometimes yes, it is asked. So not, if you look at, these are actually 6 orbitals: dx, y, y, z, z, x, x square minus y square, z square minus x square, z square minus y square. Okay, but last two orbitals are very much similar. Both of them have increased electron density in z axis, and that is why we consider them as the linear combination of two orbitals as one. Okay, this all stems from the, if you remember the Schrodinger wave equation, so these all stems from that equation only. Okay, so I suggest you go back to first semester and you might find it in Cotton Wilkinson's book, a physical chemistry book, not in inorganic. Okay, okay, so you can go through it. Otherwise it is better that we talk about 5 orbitals only, but we know that dz square is actually combination of 2 orbitals. Okay, so this is all about the d orbitals. So before understanding crystal field theory, we have to understand the orientation of orbitals. So orbital orientation, we understand dx, y, y, z, z, x in between the axis, and x square minus y square and z square along the axis. Okay, another topic that we are going to study in crystal field theory is the John Taylor's distortion. Okay, just let me see, someone has asked something in the chat box. Okay, yes, it is a sigma, it is a weak sigma donor and a strong pi acceptor. CO, someone has asked about the CO binding ability of CO. Okay, it is not a very good sigma donor, but it is a very strong pi acceptor. Okay, so there is kind of double bond. Okay, just like we study in case of, you know, BF3, the Lewis acids. Okay, So because of good pi acceptance, there. Okay. Some whosoever has asked this question. Okay, you have to understand, since it is a neutral ligand. Okay, CO is a neutral ligand. So always the compound, the metal atom which is going to form complex with CO, it will always be in low oxidation state. Low oxidation state means the metal will always be electron rich. You know why? Because CO is a neutral ligand. Agar CO ek negative ligand hota, to different tha, metal ke paas positive charge tha. But CO neutral ligand hai, mostly CO ke jo complex hai, metal are always in the low oxidation state. Like agar NiCO4 aapne likha, nickel tetracarbonyl, okay? Nickel tetracarbonyl mein kya hai? Nickel ka zero oxidation state hai. All the electrons are there, okay? Ab nickel is in zero oxidation state, that means your metal is already electron rich because it does not have a positive oxidation state, okay? So CO forms complexes with of metals which are in low oxidation state. Low oxidation state matlab the metals are electron rich. And if the metal is electron rich, our ligand is a good pi acceptor, there will always be a pi acceptance from metal towards the ligand, right? So there is a weak sigma donation from CO2 metal, there is a strong pi back donation from the metal to the ligand. So it is kind of you know, double bond kind of picture generates, and there is, you know, strong bond formation. Okay, so it is, we are calling CO a ligand because it has ability to donate electrons, but it is a weak sigma donor, but it is a very strong pi acceptor, right? So there is, this is called, this quality makes it a very good ligand, and that is why this is the strongest ligand in the spectrochemical series. Okay, so not only because of acceptance, acceptance make it a stronger ligand, just pi acceptance make it a stronger ligand, and pi acceptance can happen only in the case where your metal should be electron rich. मेटल अगर इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच नहीं होगा तो वो लिगेंड को पाई बैक डोनेशन नहीं कर सकता है, ठीक है? मेटल के पास इलेक्ट्रॉन होना चाहिए. मेटल के पास इलेक्ट्रॉन कब होगा? जब मेटल लो ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट में होगा. लो ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट का मतलब है जीरो है, निकिल प्लस टू है, तो निकिल जीरो जो है लो ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट है, जीरो ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट है, सो इट विल बी अ इलेक्ट्रॉन रिच सिस्टम. ओके, सो आई थिंक whosoever has asked this question, आई थिंक थोड़ा बहुत उन्हें क्लियर हुआ होगा. यस एंड यस
एंड देयर वन क्वेश्चन मैम.
यस
मैम, दिस क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी मैम, डज इट एक्सप्लेन द ऑल द कॉम्प्लेक्स इनऑर्गेनिक एंड ऑर्गेनिक सॉल्ट दैट एग्जिस्ट इन द नेचर? लाइक मैम, नाउ डेज द मिनिमम डिस्कवरी आर गोइंग ऑन इन द एवरी फील्ड मैम, एंड डज इट एक्सप्लेन द क्रिस्टल नेचर ऑफ द ऑल द क्रिस्टल इन द नेचर मैम?
नो No, then no, they can, are where, yes.
Then in that case, means which theory will work on that will explain the order?
You, okay, as I understand, your question is that whether this crystal field theory works on all the type of complexes which are present.
Yes?
Yes, yes. Okay, so just now I told you this limitation of carbonyls, okay? You know, neutral ligands, yes. And second very important thing that is missing in crystal field theory is the covalency. Okay, there is always a covalent, whenever we are talking about electrostatic interaction, even in NaCl there is little bit chances of covalent interaction. Okay, so crystal field theory completely disregards the covalent interaction present in the compound, but this theory is, we cannot rule out this theory. Aapka question ye tha ki theory agar nahi sabko explain kar pati hai to इसको क्यों पढ़ते हैं? शायद आई थिंक समथिंग लाइक दिस यू हैव आस्क्ड.
यस मैम.
सो वी कैन नॉट रूल आउट दिस थ्योरी बिकॉज़ टिल नाउ पीपल आर एक्सप्लोरिंग जॉन टेलर डिस्टॉर्शन. ओके, जॉन टेलर डिस्टॉर्शन, यू नो द डिस्टॉर्शन इन द फ्रॉम द परफेक्ट सिमेट्री. मेनी मोस्टली कॉम्प्लेक्सेस दैट वी प्रिपेयर इन लेबोरेटरीज आर ऑलवेज डिस्टॉर्टेड. वेरी फ्यू कॉम्प्लेक्सेस आर हैव अ परफेक्ट सिमेट्री. Okay, so it is not that crystal field theory cannot explain the bonding. It very well explains bonding in certain compounds. Okay, but it fails in certain conditions, just like the where there is covalency involved in bonding, or it does not consider the covalent interaction. But it very well, you know, the trend of the atomic radii, trend of the hydrogen enthalpy, whatever the traits that we observe along the 3D series, right? All the trends can be explained beautifully by crystal field theory. Okay, and molecular orbital theory is, I told you, it is complex. Crystal field theory, you can just name any complex and you will be able to prepare the splitting diagram, and you will be able to predict the distortion, you will be able to predict the comparative enthalpies of hydration. Okay, all of these things you can predict from crystal field theory. Okay, molecular orbital theory is good, better, always better, but it is complex. Okay, it is always out of nowhere. I cannot prepare the molecular orbital diagram for any complex that you name, right? So that is why, you know, crystal field theory we still study, because still there are certain properties, just I mentioned the John Dillard distortion or certain cobalt complexes which have intermediate spins or magnetic properties of certain compounds. These are very well explained by crystal field theory. Whenever I say this, some theory is new theory is come. If I say that crystal field theory is better than valence bond theory, but still we study valence bond theory because this was one of the most basic concept on bonding. Okay, agar aap valence bond theory nahi padhe hote, to aap, you can easily predict ki ye T shaped hai ya this molecule has this kind of particular type of shape, aur wo aapko milta bhi hai, right? CC aapka CHCl3 ka case hai, aur जो भी आपने बीएससी पीआर में पढ़ा है. तो इफ यू आर वेर नॉट फेमिलियर विद द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ हाइब्रिडाइजेशन एंड कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ यू नो वैलेंस बॉन्ड इंटरैक्शन, तो यू वुड नॉट बी एबल टू प्रेडिक्ट दोस थिंग्स. ओके, और सभी के लिए वैलेंस मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल थ्योरी ऑल द कंपाउंड्स के लिए पढ़ना इट इज नॉट वेरी इजी. ओके, एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी स्टिल स्टडी दीज थ्योरीज व्हिच आर इन इवन इवन नाउ वी यू विल सी रिसर्च आर्टिकल्स रीसेंट रिसर्च आर्टिकल्स वेयर पीपल हैव you know, done work on John Taylor distortion. So it is not that we can rule out certain theory and completely disregard it. कि इसको नहीं पढ़ना है, ऐसा नहीं है. Always there are certain improvements which are being continuously made in those kind of theories. Okay. So yes. Okay. Now my turn for asking questions, because you people are asking too many questions. Okay. So yes, last year you must have studied Werner's theory. Werner's theory आपने पढ़ा है. Do I need to repeat it once again, or it is okay? You have studied Werner's theory?
Yes, ma'am.
You have studied. Okay. So I think you have studied the monodentate, bidentate, and tridentate or multidentate ligands. Yes, ke baare mein padha hai?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
So just one example I will ask. I understand that you all understand denticity. So can you name any flexidentate ligand jiski denticity flexible ho? Okay, so now I think 5 minutes still we have. Unit 2 is your electronic spectra of transition metal complexes. Okay, so you know in electronic spectra, why we study electronic spectra, it is very much visible from these test tubes. Okay, copper sulfate, blue, nickel is green, chromium complexes are very intense orange, cobalt complexes are reddish maroon, and some manganese complexes here you can see it is black. Okay, so it is actually not black, it is very dark purple. Okay, so how we see different colors of in different compounds and different complexes, that is what we are going to study in the electronic spectra of transition metal complexes. Okay, I think you all understand that why we see color, right? Why we see color? Because yes, because transition is the, you know, is the chemist explanation. कोई chemist का person है, chemistry का person है, या one who understands the transition, वो transition का नाम लेगा. But normally how we see color in presence of visible light. Suppose you have tube light on in your house, or there is CFL, or there is sunlight. So in presence of light, you are able to see your sofa, you are able to see your chair or anything that is visible to you, right? Why? Because this that particular object is absorbing certain kind of radiation, and it is not absorbing certain kind of radiation. जो भी radiation absorb हो रहा है, उसका जो complementary radiation होगा, that is only you see as the color. Okay, जो like we call as the, you know, artist's veil. Okay, this is your complete wavelength picture of the visible light. Okay, and it starts from the ultraviolet, starting from the visible range starts from 400 to 700 nanometer. visible spectrum is something which in which we are able to see light. That means any object which is absorbing in the range of 400 to 700 nanometer of wavelength of light is going to, we are able to see those objects. Anything which is absorbing in infrared or ultraviolet region, we are not going to see this in under visible light. Okay, अगर आपको इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम पता है तो रफली इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम में वी टॉक अबाउट अल्ट्रावायलेट विजिबल रेंज एंड द इंफ्रारेड. ओके, अल्ट्रावायलेट हैव द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट हाईएस्ट एनर्जी बिकॉज दे हैव मिनिमम वेवलेंथ. विजिबल वेवलेंथ इज फ्रॉम 400 टू 700 नैनोमीटर एंड इंफ्रारेड इज हायर देन 700 नैनोमीटर. दैट मीन्स दीज आर वेरी वीक रेडिएशंस. ओके, सो कोई भी ऑब्जेक्ट दैट वी सी अराउंड अस, एनीथिंग एनीथिंग दैट वी सी अराउंड अस इज एब्जॉर्बिंग लाइट बिटवीन 400 टू 700 नैनोमीटर ऑफ वेवलेंथ रेंज. वेवलेंथ बोल लीजिए या एनर्जी बोल लीजिए, व्हाट एवर यू चूज, दीज आर सेम थिंग. एक्स सी बाय लैम्डा इट इज एनर्जी और यू कैन सो कॉल इट एज वेवलेंथ. सो एनीथिंग विच इज विजिबल टू अस मस्ट इन द विजिबल लाइट मस्ट बी एब्जॉर्बिंग इन 400 टू 700 नैनोमीटर. We, if you visit to some chemistry lab, any chemistry lab, you will see that people have ultraviolet lamps because there are certain compounds, certain things which are not visible in, you know, sunlight or our CFL light, but these are visible in ultraviolet light. That means wo ultraviolet region mein absorb kar rahe hain, that is why it is visible in ultraviolet light. Or something is visible in the infrared. Aksar movies mein, in the science fiction movies mein, we see the infrareds. Okay, so that is because they have certain objects which are absorbing in the infrared region. But normally whatever we see around us in the visible light or in the, you know, room CFL or whatever light source we are using, if we are able to see in that one, that means it is absorbing 400 to 700 nanometer. Okay, see, this is the artist's wheel. So how we see color, if something is, you know, here it is yellow, orange, red, the colors are there. Okay, so if something is absorbing in yellow orange region, it is going to appear as blue or violet. Okay, so we always see the complementary color, right? Agar koi object red region mein, everybody understands the electromagnetic spectrum, then only you are able to understand this one. आपको इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम समझ में आता है, रेड लाइट या वॉयलेट लाइट, ब्लू लाइट, ग्रीन लाइट और रेड येलो लाइट का क्या मतलब है?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So ये अगर आप स्पेक्ट्रा देखिए, this one here, okay, 400 पे मैंने यहाँ पे वॉलेट लिखा है, 480 के अराउंड ब्लू लिखा है, 540 पे ग्रीन लिखा है, 580 के अराउंड येलो है एंड 700 के अप्रोक्सली रेड है. ठीक है, दिस इज जस्ट रफ पिक्चर ऑफ कलर ऑफ डिफरेंट वेवलेंथ्स. ओके, सो एनीथिंग विच इज एब्जॉर्बिंग अराउंड 400 टू 450 नैनोमीटर, मतलब कोई वॉयलेट और ब्लू रीजन में अगर लाइट एब्जॉर्ब कर रहा है, सो इट विल डेफिनेटली अपियर इन विच कलर, येलो और ऑरेंज, बिकॉज दिस इज द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री कलर विच इज ऑन योर आर्टिस्ट व्हील. ये आर्टिस्ट व्हील है, ये बहुत छोटे पे आर्ट्स के लेसन में भी पढ़ाया जाता है जब हम लोग ड्रॉइंग वगैरह सीखते हैं. ठीक है, सो आर्टिस्ट व्हील, दिस एक्सप्लेन्स द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री कलर. ऑरेंज का कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री कलर ब्लू है, येलो का वॉयलेट है एंड ग्रीन का रेड है. दिस इज वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो दिस हैपेंस इन द लाइट इन द केस ऑफ हाउ वी सी ऑब्जेक्ट्स. एनी ऑब्जेक्ट दैट वी सी, इफ इट इज अपीयरिंग सपोज रेड इन कलर, सो इट मस्ट बी अब्सॉर्बिंग ग्रीन लाइट. दैट मीन्स इट मस्ट बी अब्सॉर्बिंग अराउंड 540 टू 560 70 नैनोमीटर. ओके, सो नाउ कमिंग बैक टू आवर कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. Okay, so that means if copper sulfate is appearing as blue in color, that means it must be absorbing red light. It must be absorbing red color in the electromagnetic spectra of visible light. That means it must be absorbing around 580 or 600 nanometer. Okay, that is why it is appearing blue in color. And same thing goes for rest of the complexes. Now the question comes, how does this absorption happens? Absorption एक non chemist भी बोल सकता है कि ये light absorb कर रहा है. ठीक है, what is the meaning of absorption of light? Okay, already time is up. And what happens after light is being absorbed? That we understand by type of electronic transitions. Okay, so let us meet in tomorrow's class. Okay,
ma'am, yes, that will be the offline classes, na?
Most probably today I will just go to the GB Singh Hall, okay, and then, you know, I will just let you know. Okay, so yes, okay, so there is one thing. If I I would like to correct myself. Carbon monoxide, someone has asked. Okay, so it is a good sigma donor as well as it is a good pi acceptor. Okay, so if you had this question that only it is acting as a pi acceptor, it is not correct. It is a good sigma donor as well as it is a good pi acceptor as well. And this is because of the MO picture of CO. Okay, whenever I will get time, I will explain the at least CO. To you people, so that you don't have this confusion. It has a good sigma donation capacity, but since your metal is always in low oxidation state, whenever it is bonded to, you know, अगर कोई metal neutral ligand से bonded है, तो mostly वो low oxidation state में होता है. और metal भी electron donate, ligand भी metal को electron donate कर रहा है. Metal के पास already electron है. That means metal के पास ढेर सारे electrons हो गए. That is why there is pi back donation. क्योंकि metal की tendency है electropositive state में रहने की. बहुत electron rich state में metal नहीं रह सकता. ठीक है? So how does it get rid of that extra electron density which has come from the ligand and because of low oxidation state? It always donates back it to the ligand, right? Just like it happens in the case of, you know, Lewis acid structures. Okay? So we will see it in some upcoming classes. Okay, study books, really, really good books, Missler and Tart, Shriver Atkins, J.D. Lee, Stupak, and Hui Kitter and Kitter. These all books are good. You can study any of them. I will just name it in the next class. Okay, and see you all in tomorrow's class. And I will let you know by today evening whether I will be able to take the offline class as well or not. Okay?
Ma'am, please take offline classes.
Yes, I want to. Yes, I want to. And we know that you people have come only for the sake of offline classes. I understand this. Okay. So let me just try today because we also have limitation of, you know, technology. We have been asked to conduct in the hybrid mode, but still we have to still work it out that how we are able to conduct one class in both the modes. Okay. So just give it a few days and it will be functional once everything is settled out. Okay. So don't worry, it will be in the offline mode only, right? And the people who are online, they will be having lectures which is being broadcasted only. Okay, so just wait, please, today evening, up to today evening, and I will just let you know out of them. Okay, because I'm coming to department, I am in the department on this time, but there are certain problems that we are not able to conduct it. Okay, so see you all in tomorrow's class. Okay, yes.
Actually, I was using my previous email that I have just forget all the passwords, and I was just trying to contact to the exam controller office, but till now they are not just helping me in just changing my mail. So will I send my new mail to you such that you can just add in the Google Classroom?
Yes, do you just write like whenever you are sending me one mail, so you write your whole problem. Okay, so I will have something for reference that yes, this particular student has asked me to change his or her email ID. So whenever I am asked, I will be showing that particular email. Okay, and yes.
Can it be possible that today if I just visit to the HOD sir and just talk to them and just what's about the problem that I will share, can it be possible to change all the mail to all the professors from that part? Might be what? I have to talk to all the professor that sir please change, sir please change.
Yes, that cannot be
Which
done.
I don't know about all the professor that is coming to teach me.
Yes, so whenever someone is taking classes, you have to let them know. You see, that is why it is always considered better that you just ask the authorities to check to correct it, because whenever there is some attendance going on which is currently not going on,